tater tots are ready.
Hey, what's up, guys? My name is Eric, also known as the Arcade Warrior, and this is my Draw My Life. It all started on July 13th, 1999. I was born in Rochester, New York, which is located in western New York, about an hour from the Canadian border. The city of Rochester is right on the banks of Lake Ontario, one of the five Great Lakes. Despite what people think, Rochester is not very close to New York City. It's about 5 hours away, but I'll talk more about my hometown in a little bit. I grew up in a small house behind a Walmart. My mom is a nurse, and my dad works with computers. When I was about a year old, along came my baby bro, Jason. My brother Jason and I have been best buddies since the very beginning. We did everything together and still do. Although we're different, we share many similar interests such as video games and movies. And we both love Star Wars. When I was 5, I went to kindergarten and I quickly realized that school is not for me. I hated going to school pretty much every day from my first day of kindergarten until my last day of high school. I never had many friends in school and kids would make fun of me for being quiet and shy. I did have a best friend, however, that I met in 6th grade, and his name was Devante. That was the same year I got into my first and only fight. Some big tall kid was bullying me all year long until I stood up for myself and punched him right in the face. He actually ran away crying, and he never messed with me ever again. I spent most of my school years in childhood hanging out with my brother and cousins. My cousins Nikki, Tony, and Haley. I'm very close with my family. I used to go over to my grandparents' house every Sunday for dinner and played with my brother and my cousins all of the time. When I was about 7 years old, my aunt and uncle introduced me to the garbage plate. The garbage plate was created in Rochester, New York, and you can only get it here, at least the real one, at Nick Tahoe's. It's basically a plate with half mac salad, half home fries, and your choice of two burgers or hots. The whole thing is covered in meat hot sauce, onions, and mustard. It sounds gross, but I've been eating them for years. My entire life, I have always loved the arcade. It all started with the claw machine. I remember playing claw machines at the grocery store and arcades and being so fascinated with how they worked. If I counted up how many times I have asked my mom or dad if they had any change for the claw machine, I would probably have enough money to open up my own arcade. I always loved the look and the feel of arcades. I loved the flashing lights, the loud sounds of the games, and of course, the prizes. I was also very good at playing games. Some of my favorite arcade games include Ms. Pac-Man, Skee-Ball, The Claw Machine, Monster Drop, and many others. Like I said before, my brother and I played at the arcades and grew up playing video games. We played everything: Atari 2600, NES, Sega, PlayStation 2, and Xbox. Our favorite games are Super Mario Bros., Sonic the Hedgehog, Streets of Rage, Halo, Call of Duty, Minecraft, and many more. In addition to playing arcades and video games, my brother and I played youth hockey for many years. In fact, we were even on the same team a couple of times. I played center and my jersey number was 10. My bro played left wing and his number was 48. I was a really fast skater and my favorite game was when I scored 4 goals. I also spent a lot of time in the penalty box and I had the record for most penalty minutes for several seasons. I might have been small at the time, but I was highly aggressive and super competitive. So like I said before, in school I didn't have many friends and I was the quiet kid. I absolutely hated to talk in front of the class, and my grades weren't the best because I was not a good test taker. My favorite subject was art, and sometimes social studies because I do like history. I was always very creative, and I won the art show for one of my drawings in 3rd grade. I always doodled when the teacher was talking, and I even got in trouble for it sometimes. Anyways, one day I started to play around with my dad's camera, and I liked to record me and my family doing things at home. I started making more formal video skits with my brother and my cousins sometimes too. I played various characters, and that is where I got my start with the love of being on camera. The camera opened up a whole new world for me, because when I'm on camera, I don't feel that shy anymore. It was around that time that I started watching a lot of YouTube videos. Some of my favorite YouTubers were, and still are, Adam the Woo, Boogie2988, McJuggernuggets, Justin Scard, Smosh, PewDiePie, and a few others. Then one day in about 9th grade, I decided to start making videos of me playing at the arcade and playing claw machines. My parents and my brother helped me film, and to this day, my brother still remains my main cameraman. On July 23rd, 2013, Arcade Warrior was born, and I created the very YouTube channel that you guys are watching right now. When I first started my YouTube channel, there wasn't too many channels out there doing arcade stuff. they were mainly focused on claw machines. I liked all kinds of arcade games, and my videos were among the first that were focused on playing different kinds of arcade games and going to different arcades. I was also the first arcade YouTuber that made carnival game videos. In 2014, I saved up enough money and bought a brand new claw machine, which has been featured in many of my videos. I used to make special videos for the holidays, and I would fill my claw machine with holiday stuff and win it out. Over time, I started to get a bigger following on YouTube. I reached 100,000 subscribers in April 2016. I continued to work on growing my YouTube channel, and I graduated from high school in 2017. After high school, instead of going to college, I continued to work on growing my channel. More and more people were recognizing me out in public and reaching out to me about how much they liked my videos. I've had a few meet and greets at different arcades, and I have met a lot of really awesome people. By doing YouTube, I have met some of my best friends online. You guys know who you are. In December 2017, I reached 1 million subscribers on YouTube, and I am now approaching 2 million. In 2018, I created a second channel called Eric Kane 2 and daily vlogged my life for an entire year. It was fun, but I soon found out that I was not cut out to make videos every day. In 2019, I saved up enough money to buy my first car, a brand new custom 2019 Ford Mustang GT. It is green and black, and it's super fast. And now here we are today. I know that I'm a few years late making this Draw My Life video, but you know the saying, better late than never. Thank you guys so much for supporting me over the last 7 years on YouTube. I appreciate everybody who has watched my videos and helped me get here to where I am today. I would have never imagined in a million years that my shy self would end up making videos on the internet for millions of people to see. So what does my future hold? The world is a blank slate and no one knows what the future will bring.